know that how many comrades are interested to know the situation of women in Pakistan. But what I'm going to tell you is not that good. Because, as you know, I'm here, I'm out of Pakistan for the first time. And I'm here in Europe. Yes, and yes, the stuff we have here means our comrades. They are the best material, the best cultural aspects of, obviously, of Europe and all the other, and all whole world. But still, I can say what we have, the culture and overall social, economical situation in Europe, in Pakistan, it's almost opposite to it. Means for women in Pakistan, it's extremely difficult to live or to survive. Because in Pakistan we have on extremes, the psychology of possession regarding women. Yeah, I can say it's a little bit harsh, but the pets here in Europe are treated much better than the women in Pakistan. There are many reasons behind the primitiveness of Pakistan. Yes, obviously the most important thing is the stage of development of productive forces overall. But we have many other things there. You know, we didn't have the bourgeois revolution that transformed Europe. We don't have there in Pakistan. In third world countries. And that is why the religious psychology is very dominant in Pakistan. And we have a mixture of religion and culture. The social values we have there are the same, are the basically religious values. And the religion we have there, you know, it's 1400 years older. And the mullahs and the petty bourgeois especially, they want to practice those values of 14 years ago. We have many sort of, many aspects of problems the women are facing there. But the most brutal part of that thing is the honor killing. Over 1,000 females are killed in name of honor each year. Because, and we, when you see the reasons behind honor killings, that is of extreme possession, the psychology of extreme possessiveness regarding women. Means frankly, yes, in Europe, in developed countries, where women, females can easily tell anyone that yes, they have relationships. It's not a big thing, I think. But it's impossible to see or to expect from females in Pakistan. And when a brother, father, grandfather, any man in the family see that she is talking with another male, it means that she is disturbing, and she is disturbing in the honor of family. She is killing the honor of family, and they just kill her. And in this, most of the cases in regarding honor killings are about love marriages. Because in Pakistan, no one asks in family to female that if to whom you want to get married. And in that case, if she have a relationship and she moved on, she escaped, she had no options but to escape from home with that guy. And after that, the family approaches the couple and they kill, especially the female. And in this regard, there are many brutal, extremely brutal ways to kill a female. Because they want to set an example for the other society and other girls and females in the home and in family. And the most harsh thing is they burn them alive. In front of all, maybe out of home, to show all the city. Male chauvinism is rooted in Pakistani society. And apart from honor killing, when a female refuses a man to get married or have a relationship, they throw acid on her face. It's also a routine. And then we have, because the most important thing, the fundamental problem is that we have extreme gender segregation in Pakistan. Even in home, the brother and the sister, they are not allowed to be friends. So, and when a boy or a girl get out of home and see the other girls and boys, and then they are amazed. And this psychology creates another brutal thing, that is that's the rape cases. Each hour, a female is raped in Pakistan. And we have the gang rape, means many males rape a female. We have this figure in every fourth day, days, we have a gang rape report in Pakistan. And yes, when when she gets raped, and the second brutal thing is she has no ways to tell anyone. Because again, it's a question of honor for the family. If they will report it to police, they will lose their honor in family, in society. So you can say 50 to 60% cases are never reported, rape cases are never reported to police. Anyone, if they are reported, we have other series of troubles for them. We have a religious institution, the government religious institution in Pakistan. And the bastard said the DNA report is not acceptable in rape cases. And most of females never get justice. The most important thing in Pakistan, for a female or a girl, when, especially when a girl is born in the home, they all have the feeling of sorrow. But when they have a boy, they celebrate it. Because a girl is especially a financial burden on the family. Because she don't believe to that home where she born. They think, yes, she's not ours because she will have to get married and go to his own home. And the pressure the families are facing, the financial pressure regarding marriage. Many families, most families want to get their daughter married as soon as possible. Because they want to remove their own burden. And 48% of marriages we have in Pakistan, they are underage marriages. The girl is at least less than 18 years old. At least less than 18 years old. And in jobs, we have the same problems as in Europe. Wage discrimination. We have a wage discrimination of almost, the proportion is of 30 and 70%. And harassment, blackmailing from the bosses and males in offices. But even in there, they cannot do anything to get rid of all these things. Yeah, I have lots of things today, but I don't have time. In Pakistan, less than 2% of GDP is spent on education. And in Balochistan province, the literacy rate for female is 3%, just 3%. And in KPK, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, the Pashtun area, we have the literacy rate for females 8%. And then, and again, when after marriage you have another struggling life, and there, if you do a job or not, it doesn't matter. Because the duty will never be lesser for you if you are doing a job. You will go to job and you will take care of babies, you will clean the house, you will make food, you will clean the clothes. And easily, most frequently, you will be beaten up by your husband. Without any reason. Because just he came back home frustrated because of any reason from outside. And when the most important thing, the child, the mother mortality rate is extremely dangerous in Pakistan. Pakistan is the third worst country in the whole world. And from each 1 lakh women,
which one?
1 lakh. 100,000 women. More than 300 mothers die. Because even when we have a different growth regarding food, we have difference between this in between girls and boys. The boys always get the more food, the better food. And females are, the girls are extremely ignored. So when they get married and when they are pregnant, most of women face extreme problems. And most of them lose their life during pregnancy. And yes, the all I have told you, it's about the, you can say 95 or 98% of population. But we have another planet of women in Pakistan. And we are the Bourgeois women. The girls, they have access to the each and every facility of life. It's extremely rare to hear that we have some rape case in upper classes. Not because that they are not they are good enough, because they have money and they can go to for prostitution and all other resources. And yes, in Pakistan we have most working women.
In Pakistan,
the working women ratio among population is about 32. It is also an official figure. And from that, even in that ratio, 80% jobs are affiliated with agriculture. Here the farming women. And in villages, the situation is more worse than cities. And when you see the bourgeois women, they have many female slaves. They have many workers to work for them in home. They have many bodyguards to protect them. And yes, we have many rich women in Pakistan. And they are the owners of factories. And in those factories, women work. And it's unbearable, the situation in factories. If you see the pictures anywhere, the pictures of factories in Pakistan, they are like jails. And in factory, Many women are very less, very few wages. And the owner is female. We have a lot of stuff of NGOs in Pakistan who are earning a lot of money to for the betterment of women in Pakistan. But we can easily say they just sail the sorrows of Pakistani women in Pakistan. They don't spend a penny of that fund which is coming for the betterment of women, own women. And they make very strange, they make very strange stories. For example, a woman was raped in I guess 2002, and that was the starting period of NGOs in Pakistan. And they take her with them, and they sell her everywhere in to get funds. She is still living the same life with terrible memory. And then you will agree with it. And yes, the most important thing is this, as I said before, the psychology of slavery is rooted in society. In all these circumstances, we cannot have a healthy girl or a healthy woman. Psychologically healthy, physically healthy, socially confident. And in this way, it's a very most of the females are very conservative in Pakistan. And it's very difficult to work and to contact them. And very few women are politicized in Pakistan. Because at home they are told that you have nothing to do with politics. You don't need to go out of home. You don't need to get education. Because the purpose of your life is to get married. So in these circumstances, it's very difficult for us to have access to the females and girls in Pakistan. That is why we have only 20 membership in Pakistan. And they are in different cities. But because when we have access to female and we get start the political discussion and debate with her, the process of a political development, cadre building and cultural development is much more difficult. Even after recruitment. That is why we have very few branches in Pakistan. But our preference, when we have the females, to have mixed branches. Because it's more important in Pakistan than Europe, I think. Because it's not just about political worker, it's not just about revolution, it's also about the simple social life. We have the criteria of membership we have in Pakistan is not that strict for women. But this is just for to the level of recruitment. And after recruitment, we try our best to create same standards for male and female comrades. Because it's not just about numbers, what, how many females we have. Yeah, it's about a healthy political cadre, it's a male or a female. What we have planned now, that we will make sure to give female comrades different responsibilities. Not the women work. Because it's not possible to train a comrade without giving him different responsibilities. And when she gets some responsibilities, we must have the same criteria as for female, as for male comrades. In past, I visited twice in Pakistan, and we had activities in different cities. We have many contacts. In Pakistan, the most working women are in two departments. They are affiliated with two departments. One is health and second is education. And we have contacts in both sectors. And we were there on each protest. 1 month ago, we have protests of teachers and nurses. And there is another aspect of the, especially of the struggles of women, that it's very difficult for them to come on roads and protest. But once there they came, they are extremely militant. Because for them it's a question of life or death. They can't come to protest every day. Their family will not allow them. And that's the most beautiful and the most best aspect of working women in Pakistan. They work hard to win the demands. And they don't give up easily as the male workers. No, because it's very easy for male workers to come and to protest. We are having contacts. We have contacts of nurses in almost all cities of Punjab. And of teachers. And they are coming closer to our workers front, that revolutionary worker, red workers front. And we have planned to get membership of red workers front from nurses and teachers. And and for the organization of for the membership of internal organization. Our main focus is on universities and colleges. Because it's very easy to interact with females in universities. Because we have a combined education in universities and some colleges. They have mixed classrooms. They form study groups, both male and female. So it's very easy for us to have the contact in universities. And in future, I think we will. It's not easy, and it will not be a speedy work. But we will have many contacts in universities. The problems we are facing. Yeah, that our Pakistan section is, we don't have much money. Yeah, we have, and especially after split, we have many things to do, many things to build. We have a political newspaper regarding workers. But we need a theoretical organ of organization. And we are going to have a Congress in November.
What?
A Congress in November. So there are lots of tasks. And we are rebuilding each department of organization on a much higher level than the previous one. The same is with women work. We have discussed to publish some material of our comrades, written by a comrade on and translate it into Urdu and get published. And we have plans to visit again. Because we don't have membership in each big city now. And in many cities we don't have a single female comrade who can easily interact with other females to get contacts or to get in discussion. So it's very important for me to go there, stay there and to make contacts and try to recruit them for organization. At this time we have two females in Karachi. We don't have any membership in internal Sindh apart from Karachi. Three in South Punjab region. Three in South Punjab region. Three in Lahore. Five in Kashmir. And six in Gujranwala. But you know, there are the regions, we have now much bigger regions than previous. Area wise, and they have many cities in there. We don't have any membership in Central Punjab now, North Punjab. We don't have membership in Balochistan. So it's we are planning to have visit again. Not just to help programs, but to go there and stay and to for the process of recruitment. And yes, overall we are growing very fast. and we have started discussion within the organization to get a better cultural level, to discuss the issues of female comrades openly within the organization. Because that was not easily possible in previous organizations. And the comrades we have now in Pakistan, no, as I told in IEC, they are with us not because of any personality cult, but simply because of our position on perspective, our strategy towards youth work, the trade union work, and all other departments. Means they are with us on political basis. Just simply political basis. And that is the most best part of the organization now. And most of comrades are young comrades. Our most membership is consisted of youth. And the youngsters are much more better to have discussions on these things. So on these grounds, I can say we are going to form a much better environment for women within the organization. Because it's not just about females, it's about the whole organization. The better the treatment of women and the attitude towards women we have in organization, it's a symptom of a better organization of politically, culturally, socially. Thank you.